Welcome to this El Nino forecast update created August 16, 2015. My name is Mark O'Malley with the National Weather Service Phoenix. Remember, we define El Nino as the measure of anomalously warm water along the equatorial Pacific. Specifically, we look at the Nino 3.4 region, where sea surface temperatures of at least a half a degree centigrade above normal must persist for several consecutive months in order to classify an event as an El Nino. These minimum El Nino thresholds were met earlier this year, with warming steadily continuing to the present. Recent measurements in the Nino 3.4 region have eclipsed 1.5 degrees Celsius above average, and if these temperatures persist for several months, we may be looking at a strong El Nino event this fall winter. There are several ways to view an El Nino forecast. First, we need to know how long an El Nino event will last. From this graph, there is much better than a 90% chance of El Nino prevailing through this winter, with probabilities being maintained around 70-80% even into the spring of 2016. Thus, the official forecast calls for El Nino continuing for the remainder of the year and influencing weather patterns. However, no information regarding the eventual strength of this El Nino is presented on this image. The other part of forecasting El Nino is strength. Weak El Nino episodes have far different and lower reaching influences than stronger episodes. We can look at several different dynamical and statistical models focused on the critical Nino 3.4 region to determine El Nino strength. By utilizing multiple model solutions, we can visualize both the strength and average of all the models to get a sense of forecast confidence and the most likely outcome. All models show some measure of El Nino lasting through the winter, with the majority in the strong El Nino range. In fact, a few dynamical models predict sea surface temperatures eclipsing the 2.5 degrees Celsius mark, though the model average in the most likely outcome is around 2 degrees. El Nino strength is a very important aspect for Southeast California and Arizona, as these strong events have historically led to the most reliable prediction and significant impacts during the fall and winter. With the most likely outcome being a strong El Nino event, the resultant seasonal pattern for the winter and fall across the United States is somewhat more predictable than in weak events. Typically, during strong El Nino episodes, the southern subtropical jet stream becomes more active often, and numerous storm systems affect the southern parts of the country. However, no two El Nino events are the same, and individual weather systems can act very differently. Thus, the odds are only tilted towards a wetter-than-average condition over much of Arizona and Southeast California during the winter, but there is no guarantee. We provide seasonal forecasts or outlooks as the probability of an outcome given the limitations of forecasting long stretches of individual weather systems throughout an entire season. This is especially true in the Southeast United States, where one or two weather systems during a season can comprise a large percentage of precipitation or yield the most significant hazards. Overall, there is little climate signal suggesting warmer, colder, or near normal temperatures in the Southwest this winter. However, given the strong El Nino, there is a shift towards better chances of above average precipitation. Again, this is still not a guarantee, as a 40-50% chance of above normal precipitation still means that there's around a 20% chance of below normal precipitation this winter. You can find Climate Blog on this site from our friends at the Climate Prediction Center. So in summary, El Nino conditions are well established over the Pacific and strengthening, and the atmosphere pattern is responding. There's better than a 90% chance this El Nino will persist through the winter, and a 70-80% chance that it will last into the spring of 2016. The majority of climate models agree that this El Nino will fall into the strong category, and this provides better seasonal predictions than weak events. As a result, the odds are tilted towards wetter-than-average conditions this winter in the Southwest. However, no two El Nino events are identical, and wet conditions are not guaranteed. Thank you for viewing this multimedia briefing. You may also find us on the web, Facebook, and Twitter at the address listed here.